I will start recording video.
Okay. This is for senior secondary students. So this is a lab in itself. Okay. That means you don't need a separate lab for performing experiments. Mm. And all the experiments from the primary level to 12th standard, they can be performed this one.
Great.
Even we used to apply all these experiments to undergraduate level also.
Okay.
And this is known as micro scale, because whatever the things we are using, they have been, we are using at the micro level. Okay. Like this is the round bottom flask. And all the material and apparatus, they are within this one. Okay. Like this, in normal chemistry, what we used to have, we used to prepare a 100 ml solution. But here, you can prepare a solution of 25 ml. And so this is the volumetric flask to prepare 25 ml, 10 ml solution like this one. So the beakers are so small. Suppose this is, we call it as wonder two cube. This is W cube. What, how this creates a wonder. Suppose you want to test it for the CO2 gas, a generation of the CO2 gas. So how you test? You can put here the sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate at one end. You can give sodium carbonate like here and put some HCl, so the CO2 will be generated. Now you can test also this generation of the CO2. Suppose I put here the lime water, then this after adding a drop of HCl, I'll put like this one. So this gas has to be passed from the lime water. So it turns the lime water
Very nice.
So I have published a paper also in that one. I have generated all the gases. So what is the green context here? It is all the chemicals, whatever you are using, you are using in a very small quantity. That is, you are hardly using 1 and 2 drop of HCl. You are using a pinch of bicarbonate or sodium bicarbonate, like something. Okay. And the best part is, suppose we are preparing some harmful gas. So these gases are not directly exposed to the atmosphere or to your students, because they have to pass from the testing gas. So they have lost their original character of toxicity. So that is why this is a green method. So all the things are there. All your senior secondary experiments, you can perform this one. Like this is the filtration gas. The bulb is there. This is the bulb, and this is the bulb. Like this one, if you press it like this one, and these chemicals, these are the chemicals we will need them. We have filled these chemicals in 2006. Okay, and we used to every year we used to conduct program on this one. This in every session of like we have more than 10 training programs every year. So every year we used to give exposure. We asked participants to work on this one, and you can see the quantity of it. Still so much different. That means it is cost effective also.
Save money.
Right. It's save money. And it is a lab in itself. Two students can work here and the two students can work in that. Okay. And you don't need any separate place, simply table there and give water bottle.
From where we can purchase this?
You can purchase it from NCRB. There is a department. Department of Education and they used to prepare this one.
What is the cost, sir?
It hardly cost 4,600, and they have a separate category that is for the government office purpose. If you are hiring it, you are taking it for a government purpose, then the price is low. But somebody wants to take it for the private, like some private or public schools are there, they want to, then the price is different. And if you go with the list of this one, you will find a list also. The private vendors, they will also distribute to choose your location, nearby locations, and you will buy this one.
There are some private people.
Private NCR, the Department of Education, they have given the permission actually, so that they can sell this one. And this can be rotated so that whatever the chemical you want, you can have. And a list. List is being pasted here, and that particular.
Okay, let's say what is 43?
43 is actually, we don't have the list, other than that particular list is there. So you can suppose you need for sodium sodium hydroxide. So you can check the list and find out what is where is this chemical.
please explain what is that green chemistry?
The green chemistry, these are the 12 principles of green chemistry. They are given by John Warner in their book, that is the 12 principles of the green chemistry. And they, that is, if you are following any one of them, that means you are moving towards the green. Anyway, so here, like, we are not having so much of waste. So for any, you want to show the preparation of chlorine, so in that way, you are showing it to your students and something. So you are wasting a lot, but here, so prevention of waste, maximize atomic energy, that is, your reaction must be more forward, that is, all the atoms, all the reactant must be combined together to be protect, like this one. And it must be, it must not be hazardous, chemicals, whatever you are using, they must be safer. The solvents, all the solvents which are non-polar solvents, which are not good for the human, they must be replaced by easily available solvents like water. So if you are performing some reaction with water or something, then it will be also considered as green. They must be energy efficient also, and use of any renewable feedstock, or that is, if you are avoiding the chemical derivatives like protecting something, that it should be the one step. If you one should use catalyst, that is, either there should not be the reaction should not require catalyst, or if the reaction you are not able to perform, then use catalyst. So these are 12 principles, and on the basis of those 12 principles, you can develop this thing. You will find it, that is, this is the size of beaker. So we are hardly using 1 mL. This is the bell plate. Okay, and in this bell plate, what we need to do, suppose you want to test phenol. So what you will do, you will have phenol in this one, a drop of phenol will be taken, and if you add FeCl3 to this one, then it will show a different color, blue color, green color, violet color, like that. So it has given some numbers, that is A to H, yeah, and 1 to 12. Yeah. So suppose we are having a class strength of 80.
Yeah.
So you can ask each and every person to go and test. Suppose you are having, this is A1, yeah, A2, A3, A4. Yeah. So the whole class can perform within this one.
And
the pore, the pore size is such a, like, if you invert it, no? Mm-hmm. If you change the size, then this will not come down. So that you can observe the color also. This is the calorimeter, like you can perform the heat of neutralization or thermometric experiments. Like all of the experiments can be performed by this one. Even the in this particular, you will have the litmus paper, capillary tube, thermometer, whatever the things you are needing, they are all well placed. It hardly, these are the bottom which are lot of things performs. We have already used this one. So, and like, suppose you are not having some source of heating now, so they used to provide this lamp. So it not provides a black lamp. You can use it with the kerosene also. You don't need a spirit lamp. Because in village or rural areas, you don't have a spirit. So you can use this lamp. So if you have kerosene, so you can use kerosene, it will give the blue flame.
Okay. So
it may not be functional because here we are having